recently graduated from Savannah College of Art and Design, works as a video game developer. Good for him. His W-2 is listed here. Now, number W-2. There's a W-2 listed in your textbook. For the tax return is just these two. Federal income taxes, or I'm sorry, the federally taxable wages, the wages in box one, and the federal income taxes withheld, WH withheld. Now, there are times, when you're doing your tax act problem though, you want to enter all of this in. There are times when employers get these wrong. And an employee has overpaid or underpaid, and that has to be reconciled on the tax return. So just get into the habit on the tax act problems, when you're using the software, to enter everything in. And there's a screen in tax act where you can duplicate essentially the W-2. You enter it in just like it looks on the W-2, and it will then put everything in its place. But make sure, even though for the tax return problem, we really only are interested in these two numbers, for the tax act, for the software, enter all of it in, okay? So, wages of 76,511.22, federal withholding of 96,51.82, had qualifying health care coverage at all times during the year. This really doesn't apply anymore. There used to be a penalty for not having health insurance. There's no longer a penalty for not having health insurance, so this doesn't really apply anymore. The fact that he's a graduate of Savannah College Art and Design is nice, good for him, doesn't matter to us. Okay, for this problem, it doesn't matter to us. They don't give us his age here. There are gonna be other problems in the future where the age is important, because you'll see when we get to talking about standard deduction in the next chapter that if you are over age 65, there's an additional standard deduction that you get. You get to add an amount over and above. And so that's when the age will become a significant, or it will become a factor. But for our purposes right now, we just are worried about these two numbers. So I'll show you how to enter this stuff.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. Okay, so here's our 1040. Remember, first thing we have to do is, what's his filing status? He is single, so we gotta check that out. Now, they're really nice. They do give us drop downs. So his first name, we don't have a middle initial, and that's fine. Last name, social security number, which is
412.
You guys can write to me.
412-345-670.
70. Okay. has no dependents. We're not to that point yet where we have to worry about that. So the only thing we have, what we have to enter here is his wage, and we're going to round it. So 76,511?
Yeah.
We don't have any of these other items.
Oh.
Medicaid, taxable, don't have anything else here. We have no interest income or anything like that. We have no other income. We do, however, need to total up all of the income. Well, we only have on line one, let's see, where are we going? Oh, we have to put on line Z. Yeah, because it says here, and you read every line. And if it tells you to sum something, like you have to, you have to re-enter something, re-enter it.
Okay.
Okay. So here, line Z, add lines 1A through 1H. So 76,511. Now you'll see it did automatically enter it down here. Sometimes it does that, sometimes it doesn't do it. But you gotta be careful. And that, I know that trips up a lot of students. We don't have any adjustments, nothing like that. Our adjusted gross income is the same, 76,511. Now we do have itemized deductions. He is single, so how much is his itemized deduction?
12,950.
Yeah, 12,950. So it automatically entered it onto line 14 for us, because this would be summing line 12 and 13. Line 15. Again, subtract line 14 from line 11. 14 from line 11. So 76. Oops. Minus 63,561.
Never mind, my dyslexia kid.
That's all right. So six. No, that's okay. This is beneficial to everybody. 63,561. Now we go over to page 2. So there we've got our taxable income. So look, we've done the first two lines of our simplified tax formula up there. Total income minus deductions. Now we've got to figure out what the tax is. We do it over here. They want us to use the tax tables. So we'll go to the tax table. Single, 63,561.
Yeah.
So 63,550 to 63,600 is single. Right. So his tax.
9604.
9604. Subtract 24 from 33. This is the amount you $1,162 minus $96.04, $48. Amount you want refunded to you, they're always going to want it refunded. So go ahead and put that in there. We don't want anything applied there. We don't have to enter anything. Now, if that weren't the case, if these numbers were reversed, that would mean that he owes $48. And then we would have to go to this line 37, subtract line 33 from line, here's 33, from line 24, and this is the amount that you owe. Well, he doesn't owe it. He gets a refund.
So do we put
down
zero?
Yeah, just zeros.
Okay.
Nothing now. Oh, except it wants something somewhere. This is going to drive me crazy, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh, I know what it is. I know what it is.
It doesn't contribute for any election.
Right. But we only do that if he does.
If he does not.
Yeah, so, here we go. Is it this one? At any time did you receive, this is the Bitcoin question. Let's see if that's it. So oftentimes if you've got everything right, you'll get a check mark on the lines that you calculate and that you enter. It will tell you if you're right. Sometimes though, like what just happened here, all the numbers are right, but it says it's not complete. Something's wrong. Your numbers aren't wrong, it's just there's a checkbox somewhere that hasn't been checked. So this is a common one. But I will tell you that my experience in the past is sometimes McGraw-Hill doesn't want you to check that. So you just kind of have to play around a little bit. And this is why I give you multiple unlimited attempts on these. Total income. federal income tax withheld was 8366. So you know right off that she's going to get a refund. Because she owes 7767, but she paid 8366. Tax Act real quick to show you how to get it. Return started.